So I would now like to move to the presentation from CNSC staff. This is outlined in CMD 17H9, 17H9A, and 17H9B. Ms. Heidi Tadros will be presenting. Ms. Tadros, please proceed.
Thank you, and good morning, Mr. Chair and members of the Commission. For the record, my name is Heidi Tadros. I am the Director General of the Directorate of Nuclear Cycle and Facilities Regulation at the Canadian Nuclear Safety Commission. With me today are my colleagues, Mr. Robert Lloyd, Director of the Uranium Mines and Mills Division, as well as Mr. Salman Akhtar of the same division. We are also joined by other CNSC colleagues here in La Ronge and in Ottawa, familiar with this file and who are available to answer any questions the Commission may have. On behalf of the CNSC staff, we are honored to be here today and tomorrow in the community of La Ronge to discuss AREVA's application to renew the McClean Lake operating license, requesting authorization for continued operation for a period of 12 years. Our presentation, identified as CMD 17H9B, provides a summary as well as highlights from CNSC staff's written submissions found in CMD 17H9 and staff supplementary CMD 17H9A. In our presentation today, we will begin by first summarizing the purpose of this hearing, followed by an overview of AREVA's McClean Lake operation, CNSC staff's review of the license application, a summary of CNSC's regulatory oversight of the McClean Lake operation, CNSC staff's assessment of AREVA's performance over the current license period, as well as other matters of regulatory interest. The proposed license and draft license conditions handbook will also be discussed, followed by CNSC staff conclusions and recommendations to the Commission on the license renewal request by AREVA for the McClean Lake operation. This hearing will review, discuss, and provide information on AREVA's application to renew McClean Lake Operations CNSC license. AREVA is requesting that the Commission renew the uranium mine operating license to authorize AREVA to operate the McClean Lake operation pursuant to subsection 24(2) of the Nuclear Safety and Control Act, accept AREVA's increased financial guarantee for decommissioning in the amount of $107,241,000. I will now pass the presentation over to Mr. Lloyd, who will begin by providing an overview of the facility.
Good morning, Commission Chair and members of the Commission. My name is Robert Lloyd, and I'm the Director of the Uranium Mines and Mills Division. The next few slides will provide an overview of the location and layout of the McClean Lake operation and discuss the activities carried out at this facility. The McClean Lake operation is a uranium mine and mill facility located approximately 750 kilometers north of Saskatoon in the Athabasca Basin area of northern Saskatchewan.
Mr. The nearest
permanent communities.
Excuse me, if you can have the mic closer to you, that will be able to hear your great voice.
I usually don't need a mic, but thank you very much for pointing this out. Excuse me for repeating. The McClean Lake operation is a uranium mine and mill facility located approximately 750 kilometers north of Saskatoon in the Athabasca Basin area of northern Saskatchewan. The nearest permanent communities are Wollaston Post and the Wollaston Lake Indian Reserve, Hatchet Lake Indian Band, located approximately 50 kilometers by air from the facility to the southeast on the far shore of Wollaston Lake. While the McClean Lake operation is operated by AREVA, ownership comprises of AREVA owning 70%, followed by Denison Mines with 22.5%, and Overseas Uranium Resource Development Canada Limited with 7.5%. The McClean Lake operation includes the joint Everett, Bates, JB Mining Area and Tailings Management Facility. This was named after the original prospector, the Sioux Mine Area and undeveloped deposits. This slide shows an overview of the JEB site facility. Key facilities are shown and labeled. The JEB TMF is shown as number one. The ore receiving and tailings neutralization circuits are indicated as number two, and the main mill as number three. Number four and number five are the solvent extraction circuits. Number six and eight represent the JEB water treatment plant and the monitoring ponds. And finally, the sulfuric acid plant is shown as number seven. This slide presents an overview of the Sioux mining areas, showing the mined out Sioux pits and waste rock piles. The Sioux mine area is located approximately 12 kilometers along the Hull Road from the JEB milling area and TMF. The Sioux water treatment plant and the Sioux maintenance shop is labeled as number three. The ore transfer pad is labeled as number four. Areva's current license was issued by the Commission on July 1, 2009, amended in December 2012, and remains valid under June 30, 2017. The current license authorizes Areva to operate and modify a nuclear facility for the mining of uranium ore and the production of uranium concentrate, mine a nuclear substance, uranium ore, produce a uranium concentrate, and import, possess, use, store, transfer, and dispose of nuclear substances and radiation devices. The proposed license is requested for 12 years to be valid until June 30, 2029. No changes are requested to the authorized activities in the proposed license. I will now discuss the review of the license application. Areva submitted its license renewal application August 22, 2016, requesting a 12-year license term. There are no new license activities proposed in this application. CNSC staff performed a technical assessment of Areva's application in all 14 safety and control areas and supporting documents. CNSC staff also reviewed Areva's past performance, including records of compliance activities and environmental and radiation monitoring. Through CNSC's compliance monitoring program, CNSC staff verify Areva's implementation of CNSC's regulatory documents and CSA group standards. CNSC staff also reviewed Areva's compliance with public information program documents and observed community outreach and consultation activities over the license term. Consequently, staff conclude Areva has met CNSC licensing requirements. CNSC staff conducted an environmental assessment under the Nuclear Safety and Control Act for Areva's McLean Lake license renewal application. The environmental assessment considered impacts to the environment from existing and future considerations. For the environmental assessment, CNSC staff reviewed environmental protection measures, environmental project interactions, annual compliance reporting, the updated environmental risk assessment, and the results of CNSC's independent environmental monitoring program. The information provided in this environmental assessment report, attached as Addendum E of CNSC staff's written submission CMD-17-H9 and the supplementary CMD-17-H9.A, supports the recommendations by CNSC staff to the Commission to renew Areva's license for the McLean Lake operation. CNSC staff conclude Areva has made and will continue to make adequate provisions for the protection of the environment and the health and safety of workers and the public. The next few slides discuss CNSC's regulatory oversight of Areva's McLean Lake operation. Regulatory oversight is provided by CNSC staff to ensure licensees operate in a safe manner and in compliance with the requirements of the Nuclear Safety and Control Act and associated regulations. Licensing requirements are comprised of license conditions, CNSC regulatory documents, and CSA group standards. CNSC's approach to compliance includes verification activities to assess compliance, graduate enforcement actions in cases of non-compliance, and reporting of safety significant events to the Commission through event initial reports and other means. CNSC staff regulatory framework is robust, clear, and safety focused. Over the current license period, CNSC staff spent approximately 4,000 person days of regulatory oversight efforts. From 2010 to 2012, CNSC's compliance efforts were greater as a result of Areva's transition to care and maintenance, JEB TMF optimization, and license amendments. In 2013, CNSC licensing efforts were increased as a result of a number of technical reviews relating to the mill upgrade projects. The increased licensing effort in 2016 is due to the effort associated with the reviews of documents submitted for this license renewal and staff's preparation for the current license renewal process. CNSC staff performs compliance verification activities such as desktop reviews of monthly, quarterly, annual reports and licensee applications, event notifications, event follow-up reports with corrective actions identified, and on-site inspections. CNSC staff conducted 45 inspections during the current license term, which covered all 14 safety control areas. Inspections conducted by CNSC staff did not identify safety significant non-compliances. Examples of such minor non-compliances include documentation updates, radiation protection training, recertifications, and the use of self-assessments. Non-compliances and the resultant corrective actions implemented are tracked by CNSC staff through to completion using the CNSC's Regulatory Information Bank tool, or RIB. Areva has taken timely actions to correct and close all identified non-compliances. CNSC staff verify completion of corrective actions as part of ongoing regulatory oversight. The picture on the right shows CNSC staff checking contamination records for yellow cake drums. Areva is required to report unplanned events to the CNSC as required by the Nuclear Safety Control Act, associated regulations, and license conditions. During the current license term, Areva provided notifications of 120 reportable events which were of low safety significance. CNSC staff reviewed Areva's event notifications and follow-up reports with corrective actions and found these acceptable and meeting expectations. Areva continued to proactively disclose reportable events on their website. Event reports that are significant in nature or may be of significant public interest are presented to the Commission by CNSC staff during public meetings. No event initial reports were presented to the Commission during the current license term. In addition, CNSC staff report annually to the Commission on Areva's compliance performance in the form of a regulatory oversight report. As I mentioned previously, some issues and events are reported either as part of the oversight operations reviews at the meetings and as part of the regulatory oversight reports that are produced on a yearly basis. Thank you. I will now pass the presentation over to Mr. Salman Akhtar to present CNSC staff's performance assessment of current operations at Areva's McLean Lake operation.
Good morning, Mr. Commission Chair and members of the Commission. For the record, my name is Salman Akhtar and I am a Senior Project Officer with the Uranium Mines and Mills Division. I will now discuss Areva's McLean Lake performance over the license term. CNSC staff use a rating system to rate licensee compliance. The ratings range from unacceptable to fully satisfactory. Regulatory oversight is performed in accordance with a standard set of safety and control areas, or SCAs. SCAs are technical topics used across all CNSC regulated facilities and activities to assess, evaluate, review, verify, and report on licensee regulatory requirements and performance. The table on this slide provides the overall ratings for each safety and control area at Areva's McLean Lake operation. As detailed in CNSC staff's written submission, CMD 17H9, Areva has maintained a satisfactory rating across all SCAs during the current license period. CNSC uses a risk-informed and performance-based approach for its regulatory oversight. While all 14 SCAs are covered in detail in CNSC staff's written submission, CMD 17H9, four SCAs are further highlighted in this presentation. The four safety and control areas are management systems, radiation protection, conventional health and safety, and environmental protection. Other matters of regulatory interest will also be discussed in this presentation. The picture in the slide shows an environmental technician taking air samples at the site. Management systems covers the framework that establishes the processes and programs required to ensure an organization achieves its safety objectives, continuously monitors its performance against these objectives, and fosters a healthy safety culture. Arriva has effectively implemented CSA Group Standard N286-12 management system requirements for nuclear facilities. CNSC staff monitor implementation of the management system through desktop reviews and on-site inspections. CNSC staff conclude Arriva's management system meets regulatory requirements and fosters continual improvement. The next three slides will discuss radiation protection SCA. The radiation protection SCA covers the implementation of a radiation protection program in accordance with the radiation protection regulations. The program must ensure that contamination levels and radiation doses received by individuals are monitored, controlled, and maintained as low as reasonably achievable or ELIRA. Arriva's radiation protection program meets regulatory requirements through effective implementation of a radiation protection program, ascertaining and recording doses to workers, ensuring no exceedances of prescribed dose limits. CNSC staff conclude that Arriva's radiation protection program is mature, effective, and adequate in protecting workers. Radiation doses are monitored, controlled, and maintained by Arriva to ensure compliance with the CNSC's regulatory dose limits and with keeping doses as low as reasonably achievable. The maximum effective dose received by a nuclear energy worker in the current license period was 6.94 millisieverts, which is 13.9% of the regulatory dose limit of 50 millisieverts. An increase in average and maximum worker dose occurred in 2015 and 2016 as Arriva restarted and initiated milling Cigar Lake high-grade ore at higher production rates. CNSC staff confirmed that worker exposures continue to be below regulatory limits. Action levels are developed by the licensee and reviewed and accepted by CNSC staff. An action level, if reached, may indicate a potential loss of control in the licensee's radiation protection program. This triggers specific actions to be taken. Licensees are responsible for identifying the parameters of their program that represent timely indicators of potential loss of control of their radiation protection program. For this reason, action levels are licensee specific and may change over time based on operational and radiological conditions. The action levels for the McLean Lake operation are 1 millisievert per week and 5 millisieverts per week of per quarter of a year. Two exceedances of Arriva's weekly action level occurred in 2015, and other two weekly action level exceedances occurred in 2016. The maximum dose received was 3.2 millisieverts. CNSC staff reviewed the initial event notifications and follow-up reports with corrective actions. CNSC staff also conducted follow-up inspections and are satisfied with the corrective actions taken and implemented by Arriva to prevent similar future occurrences. CNSC staff conclude that Arriva has implemented an effective ELIRA program. The Conventional Health and Safety SCA covers the implementation of a program to manage workplace safety hazards and to protect personnel and equipment. CNSC staff and the Saskatchewan Labor Relations and Workplace Safety Inspectors conduct regular inspections at the McLean Lake site regarding conventional health and safety and share their inspection reports. CNSC staff verified through compliance activities that Areva has been proactive in identifying and managing risks to minimize the incidence of occupational injuries and illnesses. Areva's health and safety program continues to improve and remains effective. This picture shows an Areva staff member performing a facility inspection. A key performance measure for the conventional health and safety SCA is the number of lost time injuries. A lost time injury is an injury that takes place at work and results in the worker being unable to return to work for a period of time. Areva is required to report all LTIs and provide an investigation report, which includes root cause and corrective actions. As part of compliance verification, CNSC staff review Areva's investigation reports, review the corrective actions, and verify implementation during compliance inspections. CNSC staff conclude Areva's conventional health and safety program meets regulatory requirements. The Environmental Protection SCA covers programs that identify, control, and monitor all releases of radioactive and hazardous substances and effects on the environment from facilities or as a result of licensed activities. Areva has implemented and maintained its Environmental Protection Program that protects the environment and the public in accordance with regulatory requirements. Licensees are required to review their environmental risk assessments every 5 years. CNSC staff reviewed Areva's updated risk assessment in 2016 and confirmed the predicted impacts for the McLean Lake operation are consistent with those predicted in previously approved environmental assessments. On an ongoing basis, CNSC staff review Areva's environmental monitoring program results and confirmed that the environment and human health in the vicinity of the McLean Lake operations remains protected. CNSC staff conclude Areva's environmental protection program continues to be effective in protecting the environment and minimizing adverse impacts to human health. This table shows the annual monthly mean concentrations of treated effluent released to the environment from the Jeb water treatment plant. Treated effluent released to the environment must meet the effluent discharge limits stipulated in CNSC license and the metal mining effluent regulations. CNSC staff confirmed that during the licensing period, concentrations of contaminants in the effluent remain low and well below license effluent discharge limits. CNSC staff will continue to monitor and assess environmental results through desktop reviews of performance reports and on-site inspections. An action level is the concentration of a specific parameter that, if reached, may indicate a loss of control of part of a licensee's environmental protection program and triggers a requirement for specific action to be taken. For environmental protection, action levels are set at 80% of the license limits of key indicator parameters in treated effluent. The action level for selenium is based on CSA standards. Areva uses a batch process to discharge treated effluent. Effluent is controlled in ponds, analyzed to ensure it meets requirements before being discharged. This proves to be effective and allows recycling and retreatment if effluent quality does not meet requirements. There were no action level exceedances associated with the Jeb water treatment plant. From 2009 to the end of 2016, there were two action level exceedances for effluent released from the Sioux water treatment plant. Twice in August 2016, the pH of treated effluent discharge exceeded the action level of 9 with the highest value of 9.14. Regulatory limits were not exceeded and no impact to the environment occurred. Action levels have also been established for ambient sulfur dioxide concentrations. The 1-hour and 24-hour action levels are 0.17 and 0.06 parts per million, respectively. From 2009 to the end of 2016, there were 7 action level exceedances events for sulfur dioxide, 2 each in 2009 and 2016, and 1 each in 2010, 2014, and 2015. All of these events were of short duration, and most were the result of acid plant startups. CNSC staff reviewed the initial event notifications and follow-up reports with corrective actions. CNSC staff also conducted follow-up inspections and are satisfied with the corrective actions taken by Areva. A new CSA standard N288.8-17, establishing and implementing action levels for releases to the environment from nuclear facilities, was published in early 2017, and Areva is providing an action plan for implementation. I will now discuss other matters of regulatory interest. I will begin with Areva's operating performance, followed by an overview of selenium management. I will then present an update on CNSC's independent environmental monitoring program, the JEP tailings management facility, decommissioning, financial guarantees, Aboriginal engagement, public outreach, CNSC participant funding program, and interventions. The McLean Lake Mill was temporarily shut down from 2010 to 2014 due to a lack of ore. As previously approved, Areva restarted the mill in September 2014 to process ore slurry from Cameco Cigar Lake operation. After 1 year into the restart of the mill, CNSC required Areva to submit a commissioning report and radiation performance confirmation plan report for the processing of high-grade ore. The reports provided safety analysis and confirmation of performance with respect to conventional health and safety, radiation protection, and environmental protection. CNSC staff accepted Areva's reports and concluded that the McLean Lake operation demonstrated capability to meet production targets as designed in for each circuit, while meeting objectives for the protection of the environment, radiation, and safety of workers. CNSC staff verified that Areva used these results to identify and effectively implement ELARA initiatives to reduce worker exposures. CNSC staff compliance activities verified that Areva operated the McLean Lake operation safely and in accordance with CNSC regulatory requirements. Areva's performance during commissioning and restarting the mill in 2014 met regulatory requirements. After restart and commissioning of the McLean Lake operation in September 2014, Areva identified an increasing trend in selenium effluent concentration from the Chef water treatment plant. However, remained well below the provincial license limit of 0.6 milligram per liter. This increase in concentrations in effluent is attributed to the milling of Cigar Lake ore. Areva has been proactive and has triggered process improvements to control selenium and has established an interim administrative level of 0.084 milligram per liter and action level of 0.112 milligram per liter. The action and administrative levels were reviewed and accepted by CNSC staff. If the process control improvements do not suffice, additional options would be implemented. As a result, CNSC staff requested Areva to develop a formal selenium adaptive management plan and incorporate strategies including a pollution prevention plan, best available technology, economically achievable assessment, and an active commissioning plan as part of the selenium adaptive management plan. Areva submitted a formal selenium adaptive management plan in April 2017. CNSC staff are currently reviewing the plan to ensure it meets regulatory requirements. CNSC staff will continue to monitor the progress of the selenium adaptive management process. The picture shown in the top right is the JEB water treatment plant. The objective of the CNSC Independent Environmental Monitoring Program, IMP, is to verify that public health and the environment is not adversely affected by releases to the environment around facilities regulated by the CNSC. Confirm that the licensee's environmental protection program adequately protects the public and the environment. And complement the CNSC's environmental protection compliance program activities. Sampling plans are developed for publicly accessible locations and are site-specific. Sampling plans identify the media to be sampled, air, surface water, fish, blueberries, and Labrador tea. In August 2016, CNSC staff carried out an independent environmental monitoring program around the McLean Lake operation. Samples were taken upstream at reference locations not impacted by operations and downstream exposure locations potentially impacted by operations. Fish, medicinal, edible plants, blueberries, and surface water samples were analyzed for uranium, radium-226, arsenic, selenium, and molybdenum. These analytes were chosen because they were contaminants that had the most regulatory and public significance. Revised data was provided to the Commission and CNSC staff supplementary CMD. This revised data was related to the toxicity reference values. The revised data did not change CNSC staff's conclusion that the McLean Lake operation does not pose a risk to human health or the environment. These results will be posted on the CNSC's IMP website. This picture shows CNSC staff measuring depths of fish nets during the IMP sampling campaign last fall near the McLean Lake operation. The samples collected are shown on the map and designated as foodstuff, radon, and water samples. The reference location is located upstream of the operation in the vicinity of the McLean Lake operation and not impacted by operations. The exposure location is located downstream of the McLean Lake operation in the Queen Lake area. The IEMP results are consistent with REWA's results. Radioactivity in all samples were below CNSC's screening levels and within natural background levels. Concentration of hazardous substances in water, blueberry, and Labrador tea samples were below the toxicological reference values. Selenium in fish tissue at both the reference and exposure stations exceeded the very conservative toxicity reference level for human health protection, including both adults and children. However, daily intake from fish, blueberries, water, and Labrador tea remains safe for consumption. IEMP results indicate that the public and the environment around the McLean Lake operation are not impacted by the McLean Lake operation. The Eastern Athabasca Regional Monitoring Program was initially established by the province of Saskatchewan in 2011, building on the previous cumulative effects monitoring program. In partnership with the government of Saskatchewan, industry, and Saskatchewan communities, the program monitors the safety of traditionally harvested country foods from representative communities located in northern Saskatchewan. The intent of the program is to evaluate the quality of country foods to assess any potential impacts resulting from industrial activities in and outside of Saskatchewan and to provide confidence to community members that traditional country foods remain safe to eat today and for future generations. CNSC staff support the Eastern Athabasca Regional Monitoring Program and are working towards collaborations opportunities on this valuable program. The study gives a good representation and assurance that country foods are safe to eat, the water is safe to drink, and the environment is protected. The Eastern Athabasca Regional Monitoring Program concluded that there are no cumulative effects from legacy and operating uranium mines and mills in Saskatchewan. The picture in this slide shows the JEP Tailings Management Facility, referred as JEP TMF. In June 2016, Areva submitted an application to reconfigure the JEP TMF. With the current configuration, the remaining tailings storage capacity available is approximately 0.8 million cubic meters. Based on current mining and milling projections, Areva expects to generate approximately 2.4 million cubic meters of tailings over the next 18 years. The modification would provide additional tailing storage capacity of 1.7 million cubic meters. The JEP TMF was included in Canadian Environmental Assessment Agency EAs, and the expanded capacity is within the scope of this EA. Additionally, CNSC staff also conducted a technical assessment and an EA under the NSCA. CNSC staff accepted the proposed activity in 2017 and concluded the project is within the licensing basis and will continue to maintain hydrodynamic containment, place tailings subaqueously and below the ground surface, validate geochemical and geophysical aspects of the facility design, which are on 5-year cycle. Tailings deposition remains in pit disposal into the same pit using the same methodology. Areva has indicated construction activities would begin in 2018. CNSC staff will monitor progress through ongoing compliance activities. I will now pass the presentation back to Mr. Loic.
Thank you, Mr. Actor. Bob Loic for the record. Areva continues to maintain a preliminary decommissioning plan throughout the facility lifecycle. The plan is required to meet CSA group standards and CNSC regulatory documents. This slide shows a graphic of Areva's proposed decommissioning schedule. Operations are expected to continue until approximately 2050. Following final operations, initial decommissioning would occur, followed by a period of interim monitoring. If the results of the interim monitor are in line with CNSC staff and Areva's expectations, then final decommissioning would take place. Following the final decommissioning, 5 years of post-closure monitoring have been proposed. Following a period of post-closure monitoring that is in line with expectations, Areva would apply to release the properties from CNSC licensing for acceptance into the province of Saskatchewan's institutional control program. A CNSC license would be required for the full duration of the life cycle of McLean Lake operation, including decommissioning. Under the Nuclear Safety Control Act, Areva is required to provide a financial guarantee in a form that is acceptable to the Commission. Areva maintains a consolidated financial guarantee for its McLean Lake operation. In October 2016, Areva submitted a revised preliminary decommissioning plan and increased financial guarantee of $107,241,000, the final dollars. The final guarantee increases as a result of the JEB mill upgrade project, changes to the leaching circuit, long-term monitoring, and water treatment requirements. The preliminary decommissioning plan and financial guarantee includes all existing facilities as well as planned activities to the end of 2020. Saskatchewan Ministry of Environment is the beneficiary of the financial guarantee. Areva continues to use letters of credit as the financial guarantee instrument and is a memorandum of agreement in place with the province of Saskatchewan and the CNSC covering this particular financial guarantee. CNSC staff reviewed and verified that the preliminary decommissioning plan and proposed financial guarantee meets the requirement of CNSC regulatory guides and CSA standard. CNSC staff conclude Areva's proposed financial guarantee is sufficient to complete future decommissioning activities. This slide lists other regulatory matters for discussion. CNSC staff confirms that Areva has and continues to comply with the cost recovery fees regulation, has adequate nuclear liability insurance under the Nuclear Liability and Compensation Act, which came into force in January 1st, 2017. Arriva's public information and disclosure program meets the requirements of CNSC regulatory documents. CNSC staff informed the public about the license renewal through CNSC's website, email, subscription lists, social media channels, and specifically radio and print advertisements in communities in northern Saskatchewan. CNSC held a CNSC 101 information session attended by over 100 participants in the Wollaston Post Hatchet Lake First Nation community in October the 11th, 2016. These participants included representatives from other Saskatchewan First Nation and Métis communities and organizations. The CNSC also hosted a CNSC 101 session for leadership and staff of the Prince Albert Grand Council and the Federation of Sovereign Indigenous Nations in Saskatoon, October 12, 2016. These sessions provided an introduction to the CNSC and the work it does to ensure that nuclear facilities are safe and how the public can participate in the licensing process. In addition, CNSC staff participated in another outreach session in the Wollaston Post, Hatchet Lake, Black Lake, and Fond du Lac First Nation communities in January 2017. There were a total of 38 community meetings or events during the license term where Arriva and CNSC were present. Many were Environmental Quality Council meetings and included discussions on the JEB TMF work. The picture shows CNSC staff presenting information regarding the McLean Lake license renewal to the Hatchet Lake First Nation community in October 2016. Please note that on this particular slide, due to an administrative error, paper copies of this slide incorrectly use the word Aboriginal in the second or fourth bullets. The correct word is First Nations and is included in this presentation. CNSC staff regularly engage with Aboriginal groups in a number of ways, including community meetings, workshops, facility tours, and Northern Community Science Fair. CNSC staff identified five First Nations and Métis group who previously expressed interest in a proposed license renewal. Letters of notification were sent to the identified groups in November 2016, followed by phone calls. First Nation and Métis groups have been awarded funding to the participant funding program, which is discussed in greater detail in a later slide. In March 2017, identified groups were provided with a copy of CNSC staff's and Arriva's commission member documents. The continued operation of McLean Lake operation will not adversely impact Aboriginal or treaty rights. Based on the recommendations from the Funding Review Committee, which is independent from CNSC staff, the CNSC approved and awarded funding in the amount of $75,289 to the groups listed on the right side of the slide. Funding was provided to assist members of the public and Indigenous groups in providing valuable information directly to the Commission. There were 11 interventions received on Arriva's license renewal application. The main themes of these interventions included the 12-year license period, protection of the public and environment, the preliminary decommissioning plan and financial guarantee, and CNSC and Arriva's engagement activities. I will now turn the presentation over to Ms. Tadros to represent CNSC staff's proposed license and license conditions handbook, as well as overall conclusions and recommendations.
Thank you. For the record, this is Heidi Tadros. Arriva is requesting a 12-year license term. The proposed license includes standard license conditions and a draft license conditions handbook. The draft license conditions handbook uses the CNSC standard template and states compliance verification criteria, including CNSC regulatory documents and CSA group standards. Guidance is also provided, enhancing the effectiveness of the safety and control measures in place. Arriva's requested a 12-year license term. The normal practice has been for the Commission to grant 10-year license terms for uranium mines and mills. Notwithstanding the license term, CNSC staff report annually to the Commission and the public on uranium mines and mills through regulatory oversight reports. The ROR summarizes CNSC staff's assessment of a licensee's safety performance for operating a mine and mill facility. In addition, the CNSC looks for opportunities to hold the Commission proceedings in communities where the ROR is being presented. CNSC staff have confirmed that the McLean Lake operation is a mature facility with established programs, an effective management system, and a history of regulatory compliance, and a 12-year license term does not pose any additional risks to the public, the health and safety of workers, or the environment. For the proposed license term, CNSC staff will continue to evaluate Arriva's performance across all safety and control areas, conduct on-site inspections according to the CNSC's compliance verification program, review and assess compliance and event reports, licensee programs, and facility changes to ensure safety, verify and monitor licensees' implementation of CNSC's regulatory requirements in accordance with the implementation plans. CNSC staff will also monitor implementation of Arriva's Selenium Adaptive Management Plan to ensure risks from Selenium are managed, maintain regulatory oversight of the JEB tailings management facility modifications to verify design and ensure long-term containment. And finally, CNSC staff will report annually to the Commission in the form of a regulatory oversight report on Arriva's compliance performance. The following two slides outline staff's conclusions and recommendations. CNSC staff have concluded that Arriva is qualified to carry on the activities authorized by the license and will, in carrying out these activities, make adequate provision for the protection of the environment, the health and safety of persons, and the maintenance of the national security and measures required to implement international obligations to which Canada has agreed. CNSC staff recommend that the Commission accept staff's conclusions and recommendations presented in staff CMD 17H9 and our supplementary CMD 17H9A to renew the uranium mine and mill operating license and to authorize Arriva to operate the McClean Lake operations until June 30th, 2029, pursuant to subsection 24(2) of the Nuclear Safety and Control Act. CSC staff also recommend that the Commission accept Arriva's revised financial guarantee for decommissioning in the amount of $107,241,000. Thank you. We are available for any questions you may have.
Mr. Adros, thank you.